on, or fuck it, go at Kodak. It wouldn't matter. Like, you know what I'm saying? But say, fuck it, nigga, anybody disrespect, long, nigga, anybody disrespect my dead homie, nigga, fuck that shit, nigga, it's up, nigga, fuck that bullshit, nigga. I wish a motherfucker would, nigga. Nigga, it's on anybody disrespect Nip, nigga, this on everything, nigga. Just whoop on the internet and act like you're, you know, standing up for Nipsey Hussle. Act like you stand up for Lauren London. And that shit will fly because that's the hot topic right now. So I look at anybody who's coming out on the, like, you didn't fuck with Nip like that. Because if you did, that fucking killer wouldn't have had three different occasions to come back, shoot, shoot, and kick. Shoot, 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 and kick. Nigga, when that nigga started shooting, everybody ran. Nobody returned fire. All that love, all the love you see on the internet, like that Nip is getting and shit like that, wasn't none of that love there in person. There's a disconnect between the internet and real life. You understand?
Did you know that becoming a rapper is the number one cause of death amongst young black men? Have you ever wondered why the incarceration and murder of rappers is so accepted and somewhat celebrated amongst today's society? Today, we're going to explore an example of this phenomenon. Welcome to The Rap Trap, hosted by Ayo Consaco.
Welcome back to The Rap Trap. I am Ayo Consaco, fearless leader of Ayo Nation and the Men 2 movement. If you have not signed the petition on change.org, I'm assuming that you don't have a male in your life that you care about and love, and that's all good. If you have not donated to the Men 2 GoFundMe, I'm going to assume the same thing about you. But if you do have a male in your life that you care about, and you're ready for shit like the Albert Wilson shot to Katrina Gibbs, the Conversation With Me podcast, go subscribe to her right now, you stupid motherfucker. The Albert Wilson, the Wilson case, whatever like that, go look that shit up. We will have, actually, me and Katrina may actually be doing that episode together on the Men 2 podcast, so watch out for that. But if you want shit like that to stop, where you actually have consensual sex with a bitch and then she say that you not gonna feel it till it happened to you, so it's all good. But like I said, if your name ain't on the petition, if you ain't donated, and like I told you motherfuckers, just because you signed the petition and you've got your shirt, you know what I'm saying, that doesn't mean the work stops. What that means is that now you're part of the Men 2 movement, and your job is to share that shit and make more people sign. We need at least 10,000 signatures before August. I want to go where we going in August with 10,000 signatures. You know what I'm saying? On the GoFundMe, you know we need that to get the lawyer, to whatever pawn we got to grease, to get what we got to get, news coverage and shit like that. So, you see, I'm doing the work here. If you with it, fuck with it. The real way. You're not just going to sign something. It's easy to do the shit behind a computer. I need you to actually work. I'm looking for motherfuckers that I can send. I got 5,000 Men 2 flyers. I'm looking for motherfuckers that I can send 100 flyers to. And you can pass them out in your city. Soldiers are needed. This ain't just some internet. I'm just not no nigga on the internet. I'm in a real place right now. This ain't no fucking game, dog. So get serious about it. All the information is in the description box. You need to be following me on all platforms. Well, all I got is Instagram and Facebook. So you'll see all that shit on there, whatever like that. Let's get serious, man. Let's get focused. And this is, in hindsight, Kodak Black. Niggas trying to kill Kodak Black now. The real way. And of course, I haven't fucked with, like I said, when Kodak Black came out, you know what I'm saying? No flocking, like that, like he's really, you can tell he's really that. He really was that. But he's part of the rap trap. Ever since he told Lil Wayne he wanted to fight him, at that very point, we should have known. You know what I'm saying? We should have known right then that this wasn't, you know what I'm saying, a respectful young man. No one likes Kodak Black because he's politically correct. You know what I'm saying? Motherfuckers fuck with Kodak Black because of how retarded he is. He is a very good example of how the powers that be will reach down and just, they need to get the average, everyday street nigga. They don't give a fuck how good you, like, nigga, the worse you rap, the better. Pick him out and just put him here because he's going to be the voice for all the rest of the everyday, average street niggas and shit like that. They know he's not going to be able to handle his money the right way. They know that as soon as, you know what I'm saying, his time come, if he does live past his time, he's going to have the, you know what I'm saying, MC Hammer syndrome. He's going to be broke as fuck because he's not going to handle his money right. He's going to buy shit, and that's, ironically, that's the same thing Nipsey was talking about. He's going to buy shit that depreciates as soon as you buy it. So, after he tries to pawn all that shit, the Bentley, the diamonds and shit like that, he's still going to be broke because he's accumulated so many fucking bills that he can't sustain life. You're going to hear about the same thing you heard about Birdman having to sell shit, whatever like that. Gonna be the same situation. But the point of it all is they just wanted somebody that the average everyday, they want to relate to the lowest common denominator. So the nigga that's on the street, they wanted somebody that could relate to them. And Kodak Black is it. NBA Youngboy is it. You know what I'm saying? Just pick these niggas out. We don't give a fuck how good they rap. Just get one. You know what I'm saying? Like, 9 times out of 10, the motherfucker, he can freestyle over a beat, and that's all you have to do nowadays. Freestyle over a beat. We get down the road. It's all good. There are no standards. And that's the reason why they made sure that the talent was pulled out from under us. So now it's chaos. And they're just entertained by this shit because now someone, every street nigga in the world is saying the same thing about Lauren London. Ever since we seen it in ATL, like, that motherfucker finally fucked, dawg. Man, shit. The only reason Kodak Black got the flank for it is because he's actually in the game and they feel like he might actually have a chance. You know what I'm saying? To fuck with Lauren London. Every street nigga, I'm like, it was niggas saying that they killed Nipsey just as soon as goddamn it was announced that he was dead. Niggas don't, you know what I'm saying? Niggas wasn't really, you know what I'm saying, jumping on them niggas' necks. Niggas want to jump on niggas' necks that's in the industry. You know what I'm saying? And that's why it's a clout. We have to say it's a clout chase. Somebody got to stand up for Lauren London. Hold on. Against who? All the street niggas or Kodak Black? Because Kodak Black did the same thing that everybody else did. Why are you holding him to a high standard as if... And on top of that, Game, what are you talking about? Game, what are you talking about? Say what it is. Say what it is. That was my homeboy, whatever like that, nigga, we ain't going for it. Don't put it on no, don't, you ain't gonna disrespect women and shit like that, nigga. Say what the fuck it is. Cause you just made a song talking about goddamn, I fuck Kim Kardashian and I fuck, I think he said he fucked Joe Budden, old lady too. You like, and nigga was like, man, you don't gotta do that shit to, you know what I'm saying, sell records to, you know what I'm saying, like, get attention on you. Like, that's all you about. Like, you flipped the whole game over. Like, you come on that disrespectful shit. That's you. What kind of hypocritical ass shit is this? Not because an average, everyday street nigga, you know what I'm saying, he with his people, he got the motherfucking phone on. Shit, you know that motherfucker fine as fuck, nigga, shit. Who don't feel like that? Everybody feel like that. You ain't coming out the darkness, nigga, about no motherfucking Lauren London. Nigga, you come out the fucking darkness because, nigga, you just trying to get on the motherfucking, because like I said, dog. And shout out to my nigga, hey, man. Shout out to my nigga, Urban Politics, man. Y'all go check out that channel, man. Urban Politics, man. That homeboy hit me up and he explained some shit. I'm gonna talk about that shit later on. But it's a lot more to this shit than just a nigga dying. This, here it is. I told Urban Politics, dog, if I'm a manager of, or I'm a promoter of an artist, what I'm gonna tell him right now is, just make a video make a video right now and just, it's a straw man argument. No one, or fuck it, go at Kodak. It wouldn't matter. Like, you know what I'm saying? But say, fuck it, nigga, anybody disrespect, look, nigga, anybody disrespect my dead homie, nigga, fuck that shit, nigga, it's up, nigga, fuck that bullshit, nigga. I wish a motherfucker would, nigga. Nigga, it's on anybody disrespect Nip, nigga, this on everything, nigga. Just whoop on the internet and act like you're, you know, standing up for Nipsey Hussle. Act like you stand up for Lauren London. And that shit will fly because that's the hot topic right now. So I look at anybody who's coming out on the, like, you didn't fuck with Nip like that. Because if you did, that fucking killer wouldn't have had three different occasions to come back, shoot, shoot, and kick. Shoot, 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 and kick. Nigga, when that nigga started shooting, everybody ran. Nobody returned fire. All that love, all the love you see on the internet, like, that Nip is getting and shit like that, wasn't none of that love there in person. There's a disconnect between the internet and real life. You understand? The way these motherfuckers is going hard, it really make you believe that, man, with all this love, how in the fuck did this nigga get killed? How in the fuck did this nigga die? Everybody, what the fuck? So you saying all out of all these fucking people, wasn't none of these diehard niggas there on the scene? Nobody helped? Because that's what I seen. Nobody fucking helped. Killer walked off on a light jog type shit. But now everybody, ah man. Even with this T.I. shit. See, alright. How to tell someone's doing something for attention. Alright. First off, T.I., there's no one in the South, period, point blank, that you can't get in contact with. You've set yourself up and positioned yourself, postured yourself as an activist. There's no one that you can't get in touch with the real way. Even if it's going in, nigga, you can do it. You can make it happen. If you wanted Kodak Black to take down a post, then you would have contacted him behind the scenes and nobody would have known why he took the post down. That, you didn't want him to take the post down. You wanted to feed the fire. You had to know that Kodak Black wasn't going to respond well to you chastising him in front of the world. Because once again, motherfuckers don't fuck with Kodak because he is a level-headed young man. They fuck with him because he's sporadic. He'll do anything. It's impulsive. Small-minded. Meaning it's very easy to make him react. As soon as you do something to him, his first thought is violence. Let's get to violence because I feel safe with violence. I feel at home with violence. I'm not... This politics is foreign to me. Let's get into the war part. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's what I'm saying. They put soldiers in generals' positions. I know you've seen movies where the general, the war general, is all, let's go to war. Fuck it, we have to protect. Like, it's all gung-ho about war and shit like that. And that's because, like, he's not, that's why so many different, it's a chain of command. Because, like, you have to be, war is something, and the people who are so anxious to go to war really haven't been in any wars. You've had a scuffle and shit like that, maybe had to shoot a gun, but you've never been in real war. Really seen what war is. Because anyone who's actually been there would try to avoid it at all costs. But, T.I. did exactly what I said that I would advise someone to do. Go online and just bark on anybody and say you're doing it because of Nipsey Hussle. It's like that shit will go viral right now. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is all a game. Since everybody else is faking like they fuck with him, fuck it. Just do it. Nobody, because nobody's serious. Like, nobody fucking really gives a fuck. If you gave a fuck, you had your chance to show that you gave a fuck. We saw the tape. Nobody gave a fuck. Nobody gave a fuck. So all of this shit, this reactive shit is bullshit. So you tell Kodak Black, take it down expeditiously. What the fuck? You had to know his response was going to be, or what? What else was Kodak Black going to say? Yes, sir? No, that would destroy his career. Kodak Black being diplomatic about a situation will end his career, because everybody will take his diplomacy as if he's scared. Oh, he's scared. Why the fuck he didn't get off like that? Like he did now. Oh, man, what the fuck? Fuck he got going on? You know what I'm saying? It's crazy. This whole thing is just the hypocrisy of it all is just retarded. But after that, to show that this internet shit is bullshit, T.I., after Kodak Black responded, saying, I apologize, which he did say he apologized, which is all that anybody needed. But then, motherfuckers still trying to cancel him on some shit, and I'm finna get on that. But after he say, hey, man, y'all ain't finna little boy me. What's up? I'm in Georgia. What you want to do? T.I. responds in a pool with his family. It's like, hold the fuck on. What the fuck? You baited the bull and now I'm chilling. What the fuck? And it's like, that's such a horrible look, because it's like, don't give a motherfucker, and this is for everybody, this is in your life. Don't give nobody no motherfucking ultimatum if you're not ready for either one of those motherfuckers. You don't tell a bitch, fuck it, bitch, you're going to get your mind right or leave. Don't tell a hoe, let me see your phone and get the fuck out. And then, you know what I'm saying, you ain't ready to actually put that hoe out if she don't give you the phone. Because now you have no respect now. Oh, this nigga ain't about none of that shit. This nigga just talking. The fuck is put the shit down? Okay, no, I'm not doing it. So what now? What's up? Oh, I ain't on that shit, man. I'm chilling. What the fuck? Then why did you come out? Oh, you came out because you trying to get... And it's so hard to fix your mouth and say a name as big as T.I. and clout in the same sentence. But it's like, what the... Come on, my nigga. What the fuck you doing? For all that shit, you could have did that shit behind the scene. Nobody would have known then. Fuck it, you bought your way. Dog, come on, man. You not linked in like that. You not linked in with Nipsey like that. And that's my whole issue with this shit. Y'all motherfuckers is not linked in like that. A lot more. There's so many people that are closer to you that have died and you made no fucking comments. But because the world is love Nipsey, yeah, man, this is fucked up. And that's that whole thing with motherfuckers get on the phone. Ah, oh, man, I can't believe this shit, man. Oh, man. Oh, man. Nip, man. No, not Nip. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, man. I did so. But you so distraught. You so fucked up. But you can make sure that you hold down that goddamn Instagram button and make sure everybody see the shit. You gonna make sure you got a good filter on that motherfucker. Make sure you got a good caption on that motherfucker. Might do that shit again if you don't like the way you look at that motherfucker. Hold on, let me goddamn fix my goddamn. Oh, man, goddamn, dog. Oh, that motherfucker ain't record. Goddamn. Oh, man, goddamn, Nip, not Nip. It's fake outrage. And, dog, out of everything, that's the shit that I don't fuck with. Let's get down. And then, you know, big boy with all the goddamn, I ain't playing his music no more. You're not playing his music no more. Why? Do you play Chicago rappers' music? Because all they do in their music, dog, they say that they smoke their dead enemies as joints. What's the issue here? Niggas, what it's about is, niggas trying to, they keep on, they just did the South versus New York with this Almighty J bullshit. Now they doing the South versus the West. Why the fuck do this shit keep happening like this? The South, like, what the fuck going on, dog? Nigga! Everybody didn't fuck with Nipsey, nigga. And y'all niggas up there didn't fuck with him like that either, nigga. That was on y'all watch. You should have been showing that type of love when that shit was going down, nigga. Fuck are you talking about, nigga? Nigga don't gotta fuck with Kodak to say, man, come on, my nigga, what the fuck are you saying? The whole world, man, I heard my nigga Urban Politics told me, goddamn, they on Everyday Struggle talking about, man, nobody need to drop no music for a week, man, in dedication to Nipsey. Hold, what the fuck are you saying, nigga? We didn't have black leaders and all kind of shit die, nigga, ain't nothing pop off. Are you gonna do this to every rapper that die? Better yet, better fucking... You're not gonna do it because everybody doesn't feel the same way about this. Furthermore, the people who say they feel a certain way about this shit don't feel that way. They're doing it for publicity. I really wanna speak about something that happened in a certain place that it's, this is obviously motherfucker doing that shit for the camera. But I'm telling you, everybody that's speaking of, they doing it for the, know what I'm saying? And I hate that fake shit, dog. But let's get to what Urban Politics really dropped on me. It's a rapper in California named O3 Greedo, or Greedo, or whatever like that. This nigga disrespected Tupac blatantly. And nobody spoke about banning his music. There wasn't any type of boycotts, nothing. Because it wouldn't have been news. His name wasn't big enough outside, and this is all from Urban Politics. It wouldn't have been news because he wasn't a big enough artist. But when Kodak Black do some shit as simple as saying some shit that's actually real, no disrespect, but man, shit, nigga, who got deals on London, nigga? Shit, nigga, I've been goddamn since ATL, nigga. I've been trying to know what the fuck, nigga, and I'm up this bitch too. Nigga, I got nigga shit. I'm gonna be an activist so I can get in that spot. Nigga shit is on. Everybody go crazy. But when some, come on, what are we doing? Are we doing it for principle or are we doing it for clout? What are we doing? And it doesn't work if you're doing it for principle either, because you have so many other examples that you didn't do this to. Motherfuckers disrespect their motherfuckers day for day for day. And let's be truly honest. Of course, I fuck with Nipsey's music. And I fuck with his spirit. I fuck with his energy. But that's because I'm actually in the music shit. The average, everyday, regular Kodak Black street nigga, man, niggas didn't know what the fuck. Godfrey didn't know who Nipsey Hussle was. He seen Lauren London and said, man, who the fuck is that nigga with Lauren London with her fine ass? That's when he had to do the history on Nipsey Hussle. Niggas around this bitch ain't really riding up and down. Nipsey ain't do no, I can't tell the last time Nipsey did a concert in motherfucking, at the Civic Center in Alabama. So niggas ain't finna have no, man, we're gonna turn the lights out tonight, man, at 6 o'clock, man, to represent the 60s, man. And on top of that shit, here go Westbrook. Hey, man, I scored 20-20, you know what I'm saying? Everybody know, add that up, you know what that mean, man, and salute to Nipsey. Hold on, dawg. That ain't Nipsey. That's a fucking street game that does street shit. You ask any Rolling 60, they gonna tell you that they gangsters. So this ain't no basketball pop culture, shout out to my, you know what I'm saying, big homie, you know what I'm saying, for putting that on my head. This ain't no pop culture shit. This is some real gangster shit that you promoting. So now the next motherfucker feel like, hey, man, I'm gonna go ahead and, you know what I'm saying, get jumped in this 60 shit, man, in dedication to Nip. No, my nigga. Now the whole thing getting twisted. Now everything getting twisted and fucked up. But see, like I said, this whole thing, what needs to be understood is that the North is its own place, the West is its own place, the Midwest is its own place, and the South is its own place. You understand? What's going on right there doesn't dictate the whole country. So don't say that a nigga from the South can't be a little bit unsympathetic, a little distant from something that's West Side politics. It's Bloods and Muslims up in California that fuck with Nipsey the long way and shit like that. Not even for me to go in and talk about why nobody ain't did nothing, but they fuck with him enough to show him respect like that. But it's rolling 60 niggas down south that didn't fuck with him in no way, shape, form, or fashion. If it was somebody held a vigil, they wouldn't go. Because they didn't fuck with it. They'll fuck with a nigga like Gucci. That's a Blood. Before that right there. And that's what I want you to understand. Y'all don't dictate the whole world, dog. Y'all don't dictate the whole world. I think that's the issue. That's that New York mentality and that's that West Coast mentality. Still not showing the South no motherfucking respect. And on that tip, ironically, tip, nigga, you really looking like a traitor at this point. Because motherfuckers is damn near talking about doing harm. It don't matter if we don't really, you know, at this point, dog, it don't matter if we don't really fuck with, I got to deal with these situations on a case-by-case basis. Kodak is really a retarded, and I don't like what he represent and shit like that. But what he said was a common feeling down here. Lauren London fine as fuck. She's single now. Maybe motherfuckers ain't feeling that and shit like that, but that's what's going on down here. The West Coast don't dictate what the fuck happened down south, dog. If that was the case, in motherfucking memory of Nip, nobody would make gangster music no more. That's not the case. Niggas in every part, and niggas in California still gonna make killing gangster music. Give a fuck if he with his daughter or his grandmama, I'ma kill them all. And y'all still gonna rock with that shit. If it's really like this and we gonna put a ban on niggas for talking about a fine bitch, then let's go and put a ban on gangster music. Let's take it that far. Don't jump on no goddamn nigga from the South for not feeling that shit that y'all feel. Y'all don't run the whole goddamn world, dog. We gotta follow what the fuck going on and we run this motherfucker right now. What the fuck are you saying, nigga? Niggas mourn for Nip just like everybody else mourn, but you ain't finna do all that now. You ain't finna do all that. Even if I didn't feel the same way that Kodak felt, that nigga has a freedom to say what the fuck he wanna say on that tip right there. Because that's the doors that we open. We allowed that. If we ain't like that type of shit, we should have stopped that shit when Young Thug came in with the dress. We should have been stopped this retarded ass shit. And gang, you don't have no business talking about nothing about no disrespect, dog. You the same motherfucker that made a fucking song about fucking Joe Budden's wife and Kanye West's wife for no fucking reason other than putting attention on yourself to sell fucking albums. So your integrity is not intact. Shout out to King Erner. To be, you know what I'm saying, standing up. But hey, nah, you don't bully nobody, nigga. You can do it, but nobody else can do it. It don't rock like that, nigga. I don't like that shit. I don't like that bully shit. Niggas trying to turn this shit to a goddamn everybody trying to go against the South. You want to disrespect Jay Prince. Now you want to ban Kodak Black. I'm going to stop it because I don't want to, you know what I'm saying? Look, man. Go and kill that shit, dog. Everybody get back to your shit, whatever like that. Y'all don't give a fuck about Nipsey like that, dog. Stop all that goddamn flexing, nigga. You doing that shit because it's easy to do on your fucking phone. But when it was time to goddamn go, you wasn't ready to do it. The Rap Travel Mail Consaco. Make sure y'all hit that PayPal. See y'all in a minute. Love.